in the first part of the series on making icons, you learned what an icon is and you made your own. Now you'll export those icons so you can use them in your presentation, websites, and anywhere they work. How you export icons is almost as important as how you create them. The two things you need to think about before you export are consistent sizing and background transparency. Let's talk about size first. Sometimes in the excitement of designing, we forget to make our icons a consistent size, and you end up with something like this. If you were to export these as is, next to each other in a presentation, for example, they might look like this. So we need to make sure they're a consistent size. One way to resize your icons is to drag a corner with the Shift key to make them the same size. Now let's talk about transparency. Here we have two icons. We know that we'll use the icons in a presentation that maybe will have a pink background. If you were to export these icons as is, they'd look like this with a pink background. If we were putting them somewhere that had the same pink background, they'd look fine. But what if we put them here? Or here? It doesn't work. So it's a best practice to make sure that your icons have a transparent background. When you export your icons, you only want to select what you need, not the pink background in this case. When you export anything from Illustrator, you want to think ahead because there are a lot of ways to export. Using the Asset Export panel, you can figure out what to export and how to export it, in other words, in what format. And later, say you made a change to the icon and you need to export it again. It's saved in the panel with the same settings so you can quickly make a new version. There are two steps to exporting a transparent icon: choosing only the icon artwork you want, and then choosing the right image format that supports transparency, PNG or SVG. You've already seen what happens if you select the background when you export, but forgetting to choose the right image format is equally as important. Even if you select only the icon, if you export it as a JPEG, which is a file format that doesn't support transparency, it'll end up like this. With an icon selected, make sure it's grouped so it stays as one, then drag it into the panel. Once the assets are in the panel, you can then set up whatever export options are best for your needs. In this case, these icons will be used on a website, so we chose SVG, or Scalable Vector Graphics, because SVG is the industry standard format when you're using icons on a website. Like I mentioned earlier, say you made a change to the icon artwork and you need to export it again. It's saved in the panel with the same settings, so you can quickly make a new version. Okay, so what did you learn? Two best practices for exporting icons are making sure they are a consistent size and that their backgrounds are transparent. Exporting icons is best done in the Asset Export panel because all of the settings are saved with the file and you can easily re-export at any time. Now it's your turn. Start this tutorial with step-by-step instructions to practice exporting some icons.